Okay, number 18, 11.3, we have this series where the nth term is arc secant n over 0.5 to the n. So I guess what we can do is, maybe we can look at the nth term, right?
Yeah, yeah.
To begin with. Okay, so let's look at arc secant n over 0.5 to the n. This is the a sub n, okay? Well, as n becomes large, and I have here a part of the graph of arc secant of x, okay? What happens as n becomes large? The numerator will approach pi over 2, right? Okay? The denominator, as n becomes large, becomes what? Okay? So this is arc secant n. All right, ready? So we have arc secant n over 0.5 to the n, right? So this is, we can write this as arc secant n over half to the n, okay? So this, if we look at the graph, goes to pi over 2. That's correct, right? Arc secant of n, as n becomes large, then that goes to pi over 2. And then you have half to the infinity, right? Okay? But half to the infinity is what? Is 0, right? Because it's 1 over 2 to the infinity. Pi over 2 over 0 is what? Is infinite, which is not equal to 0, so therefore we're done, right?
Mm-hmm.
Correct? Okay, because what this says is that the nth term will shoot up to infinity, correct? And so therefore by the nth term test, also when you do your test on Thursday, please indicate what test you're using, okay? By the nth term test, then you have the series is divergent. Is that correct now?
Yeah, we're a little confused. I thought you can't divide by zero, so it's it's just not valid.
No, it's not. We are not dividing by zero. We are approaching. See this arrow?
Right.
We're approaching a very big number. So limit, right?
Okay.
How is pi over 2 over 0 going to infinity?
Okay. So I like to do a kind of unrelated graph. When you get to the point of whatever over zero, to make it, to understand why we get infinity, you know, just plug in the graph like 1 over x and you draw it, and you see that the graph looks like that. So if you have pi over 2 over 0, it's the same thing as saying pi over 2 over x, draw that graph and find out where the 0 goes. The 0, when it's on the denominator in this function, is always going to go to either positive or negative infinity, depending if it's coming from the left or from the right.
So you understand now?
Yes. Thank you.